Up first, this evening, the largest budget in Jamaica's history was tabled in the lower house today by Finance Minister Dr. Nigel Clark. Our business reporter Javon Keyes starts off our coverage this evening with a closer look at the numbers. Javon.
Thank you so much, Giovanni. So $1 trillion, a big number there. That's how much the government plans to spend in the next fiscal year. As you said earlier, it's the most any government in Jamaica's history has set aside to spend in terms of a round or nominal figure. Now, for comparison, last year, the government tabled a budget of $912 million, and there have been, of course, three supplementary estimates thereafter, which brought up the budget to $998 billion, driven, of course, mainly by the spend on wages. Now, let's look at the main headings. Recurrent expenditure is about $946 billion. The non-debt portion of that is $665.7 billion. Of course, this is the money set aside to fund the operations of the various ministries and covering wages and compensation. In fact, the single largest allocation is for compensation. $338 billion has been set aside for that, with the sum considering the completion and implementation, rather, of the second phase of the new public sector wage regime. Now, of course, those wage discussions are continuously ongoing.
I should ask you, Javon, how much is the government spending on debt?
That's a good question. It's interesting to know that the government has actually allocated less money to debt repayment for the new fiscal year. $280.61 billion is going to servicing debt compared to $313 billion earmarked for the current fiscal year, which ends in March. Now, here's Finance Minister Dr. Nigel Clark during his brief presentation today.
Debt service at 9.5% of GDP, which reflects both amortization, i.e. principal repayments, and interest payments, reflect action taken over prior years to reduce the debt burden, as that 9.5% of GDP was significantly higher only a decade ago. With interest payments this year of $155 billion being fully financed by revenue.
Now, Dr. Clark says the debt is on a downward path, which could see it hitting a new milestone.
The overall public debt is estimated to end the current fiscal year as at March 31st, 2023, at 79.7% of GDP. This is expected to decline further to 74.2% of GDP by fiscal year 2023-24. Should it be achieved, Madam Speaker, that is the 74.2% at the end of this fiscal year, it would mark the first time since the nationalization of the financial sector crisis through FinSAC in the latter half of the 1990s that debt has entered the domain of pre-FinSAC levels.
Now let's look at another major line item, that's capital expenditure. That's money for major road and infrastructure projects. $75.3 billion has been set aside for that. Of course, work on the Southern Coastal Highway project continues, with the Mapen leg set to be complete by August. Now, of course, those other road works are going to continue. We have the leg from St. Thomas as well, also underway.
So people be asking, Javon, you know, where will all the money be coming from? So straight to you, how will this be funded?
And that's a good question. Dr. Clark mentioned that they're expecting to see a continued increase in revenues coming in. In fact, $889 billion is expected to come from taxes and some other miscellaneous receipts, about $15 billion from capital revenue to include the sale of land, and the rest of the budget will be covered by grants and loan receipts. Now, of course, the Standing Finance Committee of Parliament will be looking at the examining the budget, of course, and the budget debate will start on March 7. And of course, we'll continue telling you more about the budget as the week progresses.
All right. Thank you so much, Javon Keyes, our business reporter.